One study, one book is an initiative which is really focused worldwide on encouraging reading. That's the basic principle of it. It started off in Seattle in the 90s, and the idea is that a particular city will choose a book which they will encourage all the people in that city for a period of time to read and engage with on the different levels. And last year, in 2012, was the first year that this initiative came to Belfast, and it was begun by the Arts Council of Northern Ireland. We've got partnerships together with Belfast City Council, with the Belfast Telegraph, with U105 and TransLink this year. And we've been able to then initiate this promotion right across the city.
It was absolutely fantastic to be selected as One City, One Book author. I'd seen the effect that the previous year's campaign had had for Glenn Patterson's book, you know, walking around the city and seeing the quotations on walls of buildings and seeing how visible the book was in Belfast. When you write a novel, you always, you never quite know if people are going to read it. You know, you write it in such solitude and then you hope that people will read it and you hope that as many people as possible will read it. And so to know that, a whole city potentially is going to be encouraged to read the book is brilliant, pretty terrifying as well, but it was exhilarating.
This is a new city and there is a new story to be told about Belfast, and that's what's been going on really for almost the last, well, certainly 15 years. This isn't the old Belfast of where everyone thought they knew what the story was. It was about conflict and division and depression and rain. Now it's about all the positive things that you can think about, with regard to engaging with communities and about the change in the fabric of the city and the built environment, as well as a change in the people, change of attitude, and occasionally even sunshine. So I think Ian was relevant for Belfast because it's a new city and because in a distinctive way, literature, writing, story can convey the full richness of that change, I think, better than any other art form. So that's one of the reasons why I think One City, One Book has a particular relevance to the city of Belfast.
I think of this book as my love letter to Belfast. It's structured around three main visits that the narrator makes to Belfast. The first is when she's a young child and she doesn't remember very much. The second is very brief, and it's the Belfast that we'd all recognise from the iconic images of the 80s. The third time she visits Belfast is as an adult, and it was very much my attempt to write my city and to somehow capture something of what Belfast means to me. I listened to Astral Weeks sort of on repeat before I wrote this section because I wanted to capture some of that joy and youth and sense of possibility and sense of multiplicity that I think is there in that album. And I wanted to somehow write the city. I read as well Robert McLean Wilson, Eureka Street. There's a wonderful chapter where he talks about Belfast being a city being where stories come together. And I wanted to capture this sense of the city on a buzzing, sunny night and people and paths intercrossing and the city as I see it. So that section of the novel, I very much feel it's my attempt to write my city and my love letter to my city.
The public have responded tremendously well, I think, to the campaign. It's a month-long series of events and promotion. And there are things that happen right through the month, like the city dressing, with banners and posters going up in shop windows, the banners across the main thoroughfares of Belfast saying One City, One Book, all the beggars riding. And that builds up through the month as a sense of awareness of all the main themes that we want to get across. You know, it is about the importance of reading.